Hi, my name's Kent. I'm a creative specialist at Google, and I like to show CSS effects in Google Web Designer. CSS effects are mixed blend modes and filters used to stylize text, images, and video. You access them through the CSS effects panel, and if you don't see it, you can turn it on in the window menu. With an element selected, like this div, starting with mixed blend mode, we see several options, some with technical but standard names to those familiar with image editing software. To make these work, you'll need to set your background color on an element instead of the page background, so I'll just color this div. Next, I bring in a black and white drawing, and I can use blend mode multiply to make the white in my image transparent. And that's different from simply making white alone transparent. This way actually makes all the thousands of gray shades be an equivalent partially transparent black, so all these curved lines look really clean on any color background, instead of having a gray halo. So now I can color it underneath the drawing with a line art on top. And I can continue this way, but let me skip ahead to a finished color image just to show what it ends up looking like. Other modes are screen to make my black transparent, overlay combines black with the background color, and exclusion gives me something crazy. I also use these blend modes to colorize photos. For example, change my background to magenta, bring in some clouds, and use luminosity to get pink clouds. Screen is lighter, hard light combines both colors, and difference is psychedelic. And the same works for videos, although I need to use a video file type instead of banner. I'll create a magenta colored div, reorder my layers, bring in some video, apply the mixed blend mode, and here's pink clouds in real time on stage playback. These blend modes also work on text, so I'll create a new element, nice and bold, color it blue, use blend mode hue, and here I see the letters being filled with the video content, which is a different, much brighter effect than I'd get with just plain transparent colored text. And while I'm on typography, let me show filters, which are just below blend modes in the CSS effects panel. I'll switch back to my banner file, start with a photo, and add a headline. But legibility is poor with so much detail in the background. So one trick is to blur out just the part of the photo behind the text. To do that, I'll duplicate the background image with keyboard copy and paste and apply a rectangular mask. I'll temporarily hide the background to make it easier to see when I'm adding rounded corners. Then show the background, select the top layer, and apply a blur filter. I'll boost the radius, and now the text stands out much more. Unlike blend modes, I can apply multiple filters to a single element. So first I'll add contrast to lighten the darks. I'll start at 100, which is no contrast, and just bump it up 10% using the shift and arrow keys. Then add brightness to lighten the grays. And again, just 10%. And now the text is clearly readable. And you can move the mask around to blur different parts of the photo, and that can be animated with keyframes. But next I want to show the one filter I probably use the most, drop shadow. Like all filters, this works on any element, like text, divs, CTAs, even complex groups like this one from a dynamic ad. I'll add the filter, unlink the directions to change the angle, increase the blur, and decrease the opacity in the color picker. Sepia is a filter sometimes used to make photos look old-fashioned. Here's a modern color photo you can make look like it's from the 1800s with the sepia filter. And this slider allows you to control the effect. When combining multiple filters, the order makes a difference. For example, adding grayscale makes it black and white, but if I drag it above sepia with this little handle, then I get some color again. and I can adjust each one independently to get different effects. And the best part is all these filters and blend modes can be animated. Here's a simple example reusing the text from before. Just set a couple keyframes, then add blur, make it really huge to obliterate the text, and play back on stage to see the effect. Now here's a little more complex example. I've got four filters and I'm adjusting their settings with keyframes to turn the static image into a lighting animation. Because the photo is so dark but has good detail, I can use these filters to bring out different aspects of it. For example, I can add another couple keyframes, select the first one and boost the brightness a little, and boost the saturation a lot. And I'll play the finished effect. So I've teased out a little video-like effect from a simple photo. And speaking of video, I'll repeat all these CSS effects work with video. Here's another video file I used to demonstrate the few remaining filters on a video clip. Here's the unfiltered video. Hue rotate changes the colors. Invert is like an X-ray. And saturate has no effect applied yet. I'll click the last keyframe to make sure the playhead is at that exact time. Select the video track and use the Edit menu, Timeline, to add a keyframe. Then I'll add the filter Saturate and max it out. This automatically adds the filter at the previous keyframe, starting with an initial value of unfiltered, and it becomes stronger throughout this section. Then rewind and playback to see the effects. No filter, hue, invert, and saturate. That does it for CSS effects. Thanks for watching.